Hello student, welcome to the first class of chemistry. Today we will discuss about the chapter matter in our surroundings. Here you will learn about the composition of the matter. Matter is made up of particles, properties of the matter, diffusion. Clear everyone? Now at first we have to know what is the matter. The matter is anything that occupies space, has mass, and can be perceived by our sense. That means we can observe any object by our sense, and the object should have space, should have mass, and should occupy volume. Clear? That things are the matter. So matter should have mass and should occupy volume, or in other words we can tell that matter is used to cover all the substance and the materials from which the universe is made. That means the matter is helped to made the whole universe, or matter is used to made up the universe. So the main point is that for matter is it should have volume and should have mass, and we can perceive out by our sense. Clear everyone's? Now come to the point. Matter is made up of particle. Yes. What is the matter made up of? All the matter comprises of very small particles. All the matters can be broken up in similar manners to get very small particles. Hence we now conclude that all matters is made up of small particles. So here we have to remember that the matter is made up of very very small particles in which we cannot see in our naked eyes, and those particles can be classified as atom and molecule. The atoms combine to form molecule. The atoms combine to form the molecules. Clear everyone? So the main constituent of the matter is atoms and molecule, and both together is known as the particles. Now come one question here. Which of the following are matter? Here some name of object or things are given. You have to find out which one is matter and which one are not. The things are chair, air, love, smell, heat, almonds, thought, cold drink, smell of perfume. At first come to chair. Chair is an object which has both mass and volume, so it should be a matter. Air. Air also have a mass and volume, so it's a matter. Love. Love is not any matter because it's just a feelings. It not have any mass or volume, it's just a feelings. That's why it's not a matter. Then smell. Smell also a feeling, so does not have any mass and volume. So it just a feeling, so it's not a matter. Heat, it's just a feeling, so it's not a matter. Almond has both mass and volume, so it's a matter. Then thought also just feeling of our brain, so this is not a any matter. It does not have any mass or volume. Cold is also a feeling, so it's not a matter. Cold drink has a mass and volume, so it's a matter. Smell of perfume also a feeling, so we cannot say that smell of perfume is a matter because it does not have any mass or volume. Clear everyone? So the solutions are only chair, air, almond, and cold drinks are the matter here. Now come to the point. Properties of the matter. Properties of the matter means what are property they contain. So all the matter consists of small particles of matter. Yes, this is the main properties of the matter. The matter must contain small particles, which we have read that atoms and molecules. Those particles have some common characteristic. Yes, and those characteristics are laid down in a theory called kinetic theory of matter. Remember this point, kinetic theory of matter. Now come to the point, the properties of the matter. All the matter comprises a small particle. Those particles have space in between them. Yes, in case of matter, the particle must have some space between them. It may be small or large, but it must have some space between them. The particles are continuously moving. The particles are continuously moving. That means they are not in the stationary state. Whether it is a solid state or liquid state or gaseous state, the particles are always continuously moving. They are not in the stationary state. The particles attract each other. Yes, there is an attraction force between the particles. There is an attraction force between between the particles. Achha. Particle of matters have a space between them. Yes, this one I have told. Listen what written here. Matter is made up of small particles. Yes, which this one told. Those particles have small space between them. Yes, the space are invisible to the naked eye. Yes, those spaces are invisible to the naked eye. And the particle of the matter also invisible to our naked eye. Those particles can be seen by using electron microscope. But particle of the matter can get between those space without increase in volume. That means mixing. That means we know that one substance can be mixed into another substance. The metal alloy. The metal alloy is formed by mixing one metal to another metal. Or there is another mixing. We know in the process of mixing, the molecule of one substance get placed in the intermolecular space of another substance. In case of mixing process of two substances, the particle of one substance get placed in the intermolecular space of another substance without increasing the volume. This point is very important. This point is very important. But particle of other matter can get between those space without increase its volume. Clear? Now, particles of matters are continuously moving. Yes, I have told you that particles of matters are continuously moving. They are not in the stationary state. And the particle mainly shows three types of motion. Particles mainly shows three types of motion. Those are translatory motion. Only remember those name. Only remember this name. This portion, no need to read. Only remember those name. This portion, no need to. This portion, no need to read. From here, this person, no need to read, only remember the name, translatory motion. Then here given rotational motion. What is rotational motion? No need to know. And the vibrational motion. And what is vibrational motion? This person, no need to know. So, I have told you that the particles of matters are continuously moving, they are not in the stationary state, and their movement or their motion are of three types: translatory motion, rotational motion, and vibrational motion. Only remember this those three names. This is enough for you. Now come to the point. Particles of matter attract each other. Particles of matter attract each other. Yes, this person I have told you also. Particles of the force with which they attract each other varies from matter to matter. Yes, in some cases the force is very weak. The matchstick, the paper piece, we can easily break a matchstick, we can easily tear a paper. So there the intermolecular force is, or the force between the particles is very low. That's why we can easily break them or easily tear them. But in some cases the force is very strong. For example, iron nail, we cannot easily break a iron nail, because their intermolecular force is very high. That's why we cannot break an iron nail easily. Now come one example or one question. What happened to the sugar when it dissolved in water? Where does the sugar go? What information do you get about the nature of the matter from the dissolution of sugar in water? This question is very important. This question is very important for your exam. So come to the answer here. When sugar dissolves in water, its tiny particle break off from the solid sugar crystal. The sugar particle go into the space between the particle of water and mix with them. So at first what it happened, the solid sugar particle break off into very small particle of sugar, and these very small particle of sugar get into the space between the particle of water. So what happened, I'm telling again, that the solid sugar breaks down into very small particles, and those very small particles goes into the spaces between the particle of water and mix with them to form the sugar solution. Clear? To form the sugar solution. Now the third question, what information do you get about the nature of matter from the dissolution of sugar in water? That is, the dissolution of sugar in water tell us that the matter, here sugar and water, the matter here sugar and water is made up of small particle. Yes, the particle of matter have space between them. Yes, the particle of matter has space between them so that they can mix with each other. So that they can mix with each other. Clear everyone's? Acha. Now come to the point, diffusion. So what is the diffusion? The mixing and spreading out of substance with another substance due to the movement or motion of its particle is called the diffusion. The mixing and spreading out of a substance, that means the mixing of two substances, automatically mixing of two substances is known as the diffusion. For example, suppose take a one drop of ink in a water and kept it for some time, you will see that the ink will completely mix with water, and this process happens automatically, and this is known as the diffusion. Here in a beaker some water is taken, and in that water a solid potassium permanganate taken. With increasing time, the size of the solid potassium permanganate decreases, and at last it will completely mix with water, and the solution will become deep purple color. Why it's become deep purple color? Because here the solid potassium permanganate gradually mix with water. This is solid potassium permanganate. Here you can see the size changes to very small size. Clear? That means this solid potassium permanganate gradually mixing with water, and at the end it will completely mix with water, and the color will become pink. Okay, and this process is known as the diffusion process. Okay, this definition you have to read from this point to here. Diffusion in gases. The diffusion in gases takes place very fast. Why? Because the movement of the gas, motion of the gaseous particle is maximum. That's why the diffusion also takes place very fast. For example, we can tell that the smell of food being cooked in the kitchen reaches even from a considerable distance. Yes, when the food is being cooked in a kitchen, we can get its smell from a considerable distance. And why this happens? This happens due to the diffusion process, and in case of gaseous component, the diffusion process takes place very fast. That's why you can get the smell from a considerable distance. But for the cold food, we cannot get the smell from the considerable distance. We have to go close to it. From this, we can tell that in case of hot food, or in case of when temperature is high, the gaseous molecule move fast, and when the temperature is low, the gaseous molecule moves with very low velocity. So when the movement is high, then diffusion also takes place with high rate, and when movement is low, then diffusion also takes place with low rate. That's why we can get the smell of food being cooked in the kitchen even from a considerable distance. And but for the cold food, we have to go very close to it. Clear? Also, when someone opens a bottle of perfume, we can get the smell from another corner of the room. This also takes place due to the diffusion. Leakage of LPG gases. Yes, leakage of LPG gases. We can detect the smell of LPG gases. Then this is due to the presence of strong smelling. This is presence of the strong smelling substance, ethyl mercaptan. This is due to the presence of a small smelling substance, ethyl mercaptan. Clear? Ethyl. So the strong smell of the LPG gases can be observed by the presence of ethyl mercaptan. What is the strong malic substance? That is ethyl mercaptan. Clear? আচ্ছা, ডিপ্রেশন অফ দ্য লিকুইডা, দ্য ডিপ্রেশন অফ দ্য লিকুইডা টেক প্লেস ইজ স্লোয়ার দ্যান দ্য গ্যাসেস বিকজ মুভমেন্ট অফ দ্য গ্যাস লিকুইড মলিকুল ইজ কম্পারেটিভলি স্লোয়ার, মুভমেন্ট অফ দ্য গ্যাসেস মলিকুল ইজ কম্পারেটিভলি স্লোয়ার দ্যান দ্য লিকুইড, ক্লিয়ার? অ্যান্ড দ্যাটস ওয়াই দ্য ডিপ্রেশন অফ দ্য লিকুইড ইজ স্লোয়ার দ্যান ইন গ্যাসেস। দেন সলিড ইন লিকুইড, দ্য সলিড ইন লিকুইড আই হ্যাভ টেকেন এক্সাম্পল অ্যাজ পটাশিয়াম পারম্যাঙ্গানেট, ওয়েন পটাশিয়াম পারম্যাঙ্গানেট ডিজলভ ইন ওয়াটার, ওকে, ইট কমপ্লিটলি ডিজলভ ইন ওয়াটার ইন কালার বিকাম পার্পেল, দিস ইজ এক্সাম্পল অফ সলিড ইন লিকুইড। অ্যান্ড লিকুইড ইন লিকুইড, সো ইফ আ ড্রপ অফ ইঙ্ক ইজ পুট ইন এ বিকার দেন দ্য কালার অফ দ্য ইঙ্ক স্প্রেড ইন্টু দ্য হোল ওয়াটার অফ দ্য বিকার, ইফ আ ড্রপ অফ ইঙ্ক ইজ পুট ইন্টু আ বিকার অফ ওয়াটার দেন দ্য কালার অফ দ্য ইঙ্ক স্প্রেড ইন্টু দ্য হোল ওয়াটার অফ দ্য বিকার, ক্লিয়ার? অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ এক্সাম্পল অফ লিকুইড ইন লিকুইড। আচ্ছা, and see here the what is the importance of this diffusion process, this person is very much important, what is the importance of diffusion process, the gases like carbon dioxide oxygen are essential for the survival of aquatic plant and the animal, the every kind of animal or plant need oxygen and carbon dioxide for their survival, and also this also true for the aquatic animal, from where the aquatic animal get their oxygen and carbon dioxide, they will get those oxygen and carbon dioxide from dissolved oxygen and carbon dioxide, and those carbon dioxide and oxygen dissolve in water through the diffusion process, those oxygen and carbon dioxide dissolve in water through the diffusion process, and that aquatic animal and plant can take this oxygen and carbon dioxide for their respiration or photosynthesis process respectively, clear? And diffusion of solid, and diffusion of solid is very slow, because diffusion of solid is very slow, why it's very slow, because the movement of the solid particle is very very slow process, the movement of the solid particle is very slow, that's why diffusion in solid also very slow. আচ্ছা, বাট ইন সলিড সাবস্টান্স দ্য ডিফিউশন অলসো টেক প্লেস, ওয়ান এক্সাম্পল, দিস এক্সাম্পল ইজ ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট, ইফ ইউ রাইট সামথিং অন এ ব্ল্যাক বোর্ড অ্যান্ড লিভ ইট আনক্লিন ফর আ কনসিডারেবল পিরিয়ড অফ টাইম, উইল ফাইন্ড দ্যাট ইট বিকামস কোয়াইট ডিফিকাল্ট টু ক্লিন দ্য ব্যাক ব্ল্যাক বোর্ড আফটার ওয়ার্ড, ইফ ইউ রাইট সামথিং অন এ ব্ল্যাক বোর্ড অ্যান্ড লিভ ইট আনক্লিন ফর আ কনসিডারেবল পিরিয়ড অফ টাইম, উইল ফাইন্ড দ্যাট ইট বিকামস কোয়াইট ডিফিকাল্ট টু ক্লিন দ্য ব্ল্যাক বোর্ড After all, this is due to the fact that some of the particle of chalk have diffused into the surface of the blackboard. Yes, if we kept a blackboard unclean for several days, and after then if we want to clean it, it's not easy to clean that board, because some chalk particle diffused through the blackboard, and that's why we cannot properly clean this, and this happens due to the diffusion process, clear? আচ্ছা, সো হোয়াট ইউ হ্যাভ লার্ন ফ্রম হিয়ার, গ্যাসেস ডিফিউজ ভেরি র্যাপিডলি, দ্য রেট অফ ডিফিউশন অফ গ্যাসেস ভ্যারিস ইনভার্সলি অ্যাজ দ্য স্কোয়ার রুট অফ দেয়ার ডেন্সিটি, দিস ইজ ইম্পর্টেন্ট, দ্য রেট অফ ডিফিউশন অফ এ গ্যাস, দ্য রেট অফ ডিফিউশন, সো দ্য রেট অফ ডিফিউশন অফ এ গ্যাস ভ্যারিস ইনভার্সলি অ্যাজ স্কোয়ার রুট অফ ডেন্সিটি, দ্য রেট অফ ডিফিউশন অফ এ গ্যাস ভ্যারিস ইনভার্সলি অ্যাজ দ্য স্কোয়ার রুট অফ ইটস ডেন্সিটি, দিস পার্সন হ্যাভ টু রিমেম্বার প্রপারলি। Now another thing is the force of attraction or cohesion force. What is the cohesion force? There is some force of attraction between the particle of the matter which bind them together. There is some force of attraction between the particles of matter which bind them together. This force of attraction between the particle of same substance is known as the force of attraction or cohesion force. So the attraction force between the same kind of substance particle, same kind of substance particle or particle of same kind substance is known as the force of attraction or cohesion force. Clear everyone? The force of attraction between the particle of same substance is known as the force of attraction. For example, the attraction force between the water molecule, or attraction force between the two iron molecule or iron atom. Okay, those are known as the force of attraction or cohesion force. Clear? Achha. And here is the find the rate of diffusion in various state of matter, that is solid, gas, liquid, and this one you have to remember solid, liquid, and then gases. That means in case of gases, diffusion process is fast, in case of liquid it's moderate, and in case of solid it is least. Clear? So that's all for today. Goodbye.